Okay, so things are like in your setup as is are the following. Club face is perfectly fine, positioned at a squared up position behind the ball. Club and ball are in the middle of your feet. Feet, hips, and shoulders, for the most part, are lined up complementary to the leading edge of the club face. And both hands are working well as a unit, as far as your grip is concerned. But we got closer and closer to the ball, and we got more and more in your heels with your body weight, right? I want to be able to actually step back a little bit from the ball and be on the balls of your feet as opposed to your heels, and that's going to give you better stability and more space is key for you. Because you didn't have a lot of room, and the less room you had, the more the club got stuck and you got crowded, right? So stepping back and really just keeping the connection. As long as the backs of your upper arms stay on your chest, it's amazing how far you can step back, right? Mm-hmm. As soon as your arms are off your chest, then that will be exaggerating on the other end, right? So space and balance are key for you. As the club goes away from the ball, you can see how the club moves away from the ball because you got to go that way so you don't fall over, right? So you get too close as well. So the club head goes out or away, and then you pick it up with your arms and hands and pick it up over your shoulder. And a little bit of an overswing, but more that look how much room there is or daylight between your legs. You're kind of going back with your arms and then pulling your legs apart. So your contact is 100% reliant on how well you time this. Clearing the left hip, reflexing the right knee and dropping the arms down. And as you can see, you came outside the ball line again or in front of it and cut across on it. So more of a direct takeaway path would be your focus with more space so you can return that way naturally and hit it clear and a lot more solid, better in the face.
Okay. All right.
So cool. Something to work